0 pucks given.
Hello and welcome to Zero Pucks Given, the UK ice hockey podcast. We are in partnership with Blades Belong on Your Feet, the charity fighting knife crime with ice skating all across the UK. And we are in partnership with Hockey Art Co., the clothing company for you hockey fans. Worn by the best, hated by the rest. Zero Pucks Given listeners get a 10% discount on everything on the Hockey Art Co. website. If you enter the code ZP10 upon checkout, you'll get your discount on anything that you like from their website. So go there and check it out. Once you finish listening to this, of course. This is episode 41. We are still in the Britton Season Preview with myself and Anthony Russell. And this episode is all about the newly named Romford Buccaneers. So we will now move back into Essex and onto the very newly named Romford Buccaneers. They have, as you said, a good challenging weekend that they've just had, a sort of a head and home with the Haringey Huskies. They come out on top both times, but that was a good workout for them.
Yeah, probably more than they may have necessarily been expecting, but certainly I think it's no bad thing, I think, in that sense. The thing, of course, with the team like the Buccaneers, the other Buccaneers, because of course they are now the second Buccaneer side in the NIHL structure, thanks to Billingham deciding to name their second team the same thing.
Yeah. But
I'm always interested with these teams that are the second teams in the rink of what's the goal, kind of thing, because again, I'm sorry if you're a really loyal Buccaneers watcher, I don't think they're winning the title. Sorry. But there's some really interesting names on it. Albeit at the moment, Elite Prospects has them having five defensemen and one goalie, who's your friend Sonny Phillips. You assume that the under 18s are getting very heftily called on to kind of come in and join the party there, but there is a, they, like I say, teams like this, I'm always very, and especially as well, where you consider, and we'll obviously talk about the Thunder in a bit, but there's much less of a, the link up is much less talked about. And obviously you've got, like I say, I mean, 13 forwards, 5D and one goalie is a very odd makeup of a roster, but they've got some little names in there. Elliot Dervish is a name who just seems to be around forever. but it was also, there's Louis Kinniston, Luca Mascali. Like there's a bit of talent in there, but they're an interesting bunch. I think though like you mentioned when you talked about like season ticket prices and things like that, I believe you said these guys have the lowest price, like the lowest entry price in the division. Was I right in that?
Yes.
Yeah,
and there's a reason for that. £115, yeah.
Yeah, and there's a reason for that.
Yeah.
But you get the opportunity to see, I mean, aside from the fact, Ellie Wakeling is, in women's hockey has, a vast amount of quality. She's able to play in this as well. So she gets to add an extra dimension to her game. Guys get to play with someone who has, got a vast amount of talent in a different sphere of the game, because there's a difference between men and women's hockey, but there's so much kind of potential in that, and it's just watching. If you're going and watching a Buccaneers game, you're not much so much watching for the result. You'd like Romford to win, I assume, if you're a Romford fan, but you are watching potential personified, right? Yeah. This is about guys pushing on, and who's going to be the next up? Will it be TJ Anderson? Will it be Marco Pascali, who not long ago were on that roster. And last, you know, a couple of months ago, absolutely showed up and showed out in Coventry. Who's the next person to do that? Who's the next person that, that Sean Easton's going to pluck out of that roster and be the next big name for the Raiders? Like, that's a cool feeling. That's pretty cool, I think.
Yeah. Yeah. That when TJ Anderson from last year was just incredible.
Yeah, he's ridiculous. He's utterly ridiculous.
Yeah. For that level, we just, yeah, absolutely. And even in the national playoffs, he stepped straight up from doing the Britton playoffs at Milton Keynes, then went up to the national playoffs with the Raiders and just had an exceptional weekend.
Yep.
So in all honesty, because of how good their ticket prices was, my wife's trying to force me to drive another 20 miles up the A12. She said it'd be cheaper on fuel for you to drive to Romford. But the they've with their young guys coming through, and they have taken two from Chelmsford, Joe Tamarlin, absolutely quality player. I'd like to see him get a bit of time with the Buccaneers this year rather than step straight into the Raiders. Brindley Capps, of course, is Ellie Wakelin's brother.
Yeah.
So he's in there. They both had incredibly successful starts this weekend. So that's quite exciting for them Romford fans if they can get to see that, as you say, potential personified.
Yeah.
With those young players. I think most Romford fans would take beating Chelmsford four times as a successful season.
Yeah, there's acceptable results. As a basing set fan, you settle for beating the Bees six times. Yeah. And then just sod the rest of the league campaign, I think was sometimes how it felt. But like you say, you get a bit of a local derby, which is a bit nice. You get the opportunity to, and again, even maybe more so than kind of Oxford, because like I said, we just mentioned about Oxford, I think their potential to kind of push up and push on is much higher than this group. I'm sorry to say for Romford fans, but this is a team that's here to hand up bloody noses.
Yeah.
Turn up in Romford and don't put the effort in at your peril, I think is kind of the big message here. And obviously, like, you know, Haringey are a team, are an organization on the up. You know, they've got the Plexi in at Ali Pali. They've got plans to move up. They've got, you know, they've got a lot of guys who, you know, Haringey is an organization with energy and excitement around it. And they need to be able to prove
that
they can.
From what I hear, that's a done deal.
That's a done deal. Yeah. It is. It's going to happen. But I think the thing, of course, is that organization with all its energy and all of the excitement around it, Romford went, nah, mate, we're not playing that game. We're not excited about you. And push them aside. Obviously, they didn't give them sort of a great big whack or anything like that. But a win is a win is a win. And in pre-season, when you're trying to, you know, Romford are heading in, the Buccaneers are heading to a really competitive South One, where they do not look like one of the strongest sides. Wins confidence.
Yeah,
that's important.
But like you said, I think their big thing is definitely going to be if you turn up at Romford at the Sapphire unprepared, they're going to hand you your ass on a plate.
Yeah, or they'll do even worse and just like nick it from me right at the end, make you feel really bad. Make you feel
They've
really
done that
bad
to
about
us
yourself
once or twice, and that's really heartbreaking. So,
yeah, I mean
that happens quite early actually in the season. The Essex Derby, I think it's next Saturday, the 23rd. So that happens early.
We'll see how accurate we were on that one. I think really though, for me, the ceiling and the floor are both in the bottom half for Romford, if we're honest with ourselves. I think I find it interesting because having just opened up the table on Elite Prospects, there's no results on it, obviously, despite the fact there's been a game played. But Romford, it puts them alphabetically in fifth. I think fifth is the highest that Romford will go. The floor for them is the bottom because it unfortunately just is, especially with the fact that Milton Keynes are a bit retooled and a bit different looking, albeit the result from the weekend was, you know, very much kind of mirrored some of the stuff we saw last year. But I don't see a top half finish for the Buccaneers. What I see for them doing is to, like I say, just, you know, throw their weight around a bit. Yeah, like we said, if people don't turn up, you know, if you fail to prepare and you go to Romford with that attitude, prepare to fail. They will beat you.
Yeah, I've got them as seventh, but not far from sixth, slightly ahead of eighth. as you said, I think they'll pick up some results that will sort of look like highlights towards the end of the season. You know, they probably will nick one of the four at least off of Chelmsford. They could well, you know, nick a point off of an Invicta or a Solent. I mean, with the Solent, with the way Solent have rebuilt, and if Buccaneers have a full squad available, Solent against Buccaneers sounds like a barnstormer to me.
Yeah. Yeah. Could be. Yeah. Very, very much so.
So yeah, there's definitely a potential for some great results there. And as you say, being a development side for the National League, they know what they're there to do. They're not really there to go and challenge the top two or three in this division. But they've got some great young players, and I'm sure they're going to make a really great show. And they also have one of the best jerseys in the league.
Not a personal favourite of mine, I have to say, but fair play to them. It can be a thankless task playing in a side like that. But yeah, you know, the future is there for a lot of those young guys to do some damage.
Yeah, they work very hard as well, and as you said, they'll turn up and they'll play every game 100%. They give 100% for Jason Buckman. He's also kind enough to give his time up for the podcast as well and give his thoughts. So, yeah, despite the rivalry, I love what Romford do. Without Romford, you know, we wouldn't have a proper rival in Essex. So it's certainly one I'm looking forward to. This podcast is hosted by Spotify for Podcasters. It is available on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Amazon Music, and anywhere else that you get your podcasts. You can follow on all the social medias. It's at Zero Pucks Given for YouTube and Facebook, at Zero Pucks Given Podcast for Instagram, TikTok, and Threads, at Zero Pucks Pod on X, and Ben Hyde ZPG on Snapchat. Follow us on all of those, and you will not miss a thing. Thanks for listening, and we'll see you next time.